Hi Scorpio, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to another Love Bite. Simple 9th card spread Scorpio, just to check on what messages want to show through for you today. And these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you, leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Scorpio and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Scorpio, let's begin your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here again. I'm very, very grateful for all your lovely support to the channel, your likes, your comments. Thank you. And Scorpio, if you're new here, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. So Scorpio, Queen of Cups, center of my spread. Okay, I think this Queen of Cups has gone into self-love, healing themselves. That's my first thought when I saw her. Let's see. Okay. Also has boundaries up now. My God, Queen of Swords as my overall energy for the reading. Not taking any more bullshit, it seems, Scorpio. So somebody's feeling a little down and out here, Scorpio. Feeling there's nothing to look forward to, no excitement to look forward to, there is no hope for happiness or rejoicing or reconciliations, almost feeling like, you know, feeling dropped. Maybe by this Queen of Cups who walked away and is healing their own life, they're giving themselves self-love, looking after themselves. Now somebody is feeling rather foolish, they feel that I've made some very unwise decisions. They still want to hold on though. They still want to hold on to, I mean, who wouldn't want to hold on to this Queen of Cups? But let's see what's going to happen. I'm going to start with some dialogue message cards, Scorpio, within the two of you, if you guys could say something to each other, and then we'll start the clarification. So Scorpio and their person spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? And Scorpio, if any of you are looking for a personal reading, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Scorpio and that person. I'm going to take a few more Scorpio from here. Scorpio and that person. Scorpio and that person. Thank you. And one or two more from here. And then we are good to go, Scorpio and that person. Thank you. All right. So Scorpio, the first card here says, I get so annoyed with your constant need to control everything and your denial of your triggers. If I upset you, I want you to be honest with me, but you use silence as a manipulation to gain control. We should be able to talk it out like grown-ups. So somebody is now feeling they made some unwise choices in their life. Maybe they behaved badly and this Queen of Cups could have said, I can't take this controlling person in my life anymore. You have half our gifts, I the other. If you would only work with me instead of being silent and shutting me out, we could overcome any obstacles together and heal in sacred union. Don't come back to me if you haven't leveled up. I knew all along that you had the potential to run again, but the intensity of our connection and my curiosity about it is what kept me interested in you. My boundaries are much stronger now. See, that's the Queen of Swords talking. My boundaries are stronger now and your old mind games will no longer be tolerated. It's almost like this Ten of Wands giving up, right? Okay. Next card says, you feed my heart and my soul with your love. You're my best friend, my passionate lover. I love you more than anything in this world. I would wait for eternity to be with you. I will never let you go. You are my one true love. I've been waiting a lifetime for you. Though I haven't always said it with words, there is love in the silence. Close your eyes and feel my presence. be still and listen to me tell you that I love you. I didn't think it was possible to feel this much. Thoughts of you fill my head. It's the little things you do that make you so special. And the last one here says, I have unresolved feelings that I need to work through. So Scorpio, if these messages are resonating with your storyline, let's start with some dialogue message cards. My angels, what do you have for my Scorpio gang? Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message? Steady progress. Yeah, somebody is healing themselves now, I think, giving themselves self-care, self-love, making steady progress, slow and steady, in their own life. So, I don't know which side you are on, Scorpio, but I'm just going to read the cards as I see. Ace of Wands spirit, Ace of Wands in reverse. Ace of Wands, yeah, somebody's not being able to bring justice or heal the situation between the two of you or balance it out again, feeling rather unmotivated. But yes, this Four of Pentacles is here again. Still holding on, not wanting to let go, even though things are not balanced right now in this connection. Three of Cups in reverse. There is no sign of... I don't think this queen really is looking for a reconciliation. They could have leveled up now because I see them healed now. They could have now taken off on a journey for themselves or maybe turned their back to this past person, maybe looking out to see what else is out there, looking good, feeling good, glowing and very passionate about, you know, this new journey of theirs. They've taken some time out in a lot of healing, it seems, given themselves a lot of self-care after dropping something. Two of Pentacles in reverse. What's this spirit? Two of Pentacles in reverse. Yes, dropping all this stress and tension, maybe in this connection, not looking back anymore in regret and sorrow or upset of always, you know, wishing that, you know, I wish this didn't happen, that didn't happen. I think this Queen of Wands picked themselves up, healed themselves, and has turned both these cards upside down for me to say, hey, no more. I'm the Queen of Wands. I can move on. I live in my present and I live in my future. The past is over for me. I've already dropped it here. So, Eight of Cups, Spirit. Eight of Cups. Yes, like I said, somebody has moved on to a peaceful place from themselves. Maybe they were dealing with a magician in reverse, somebody who was a trickster, not being honest with them or not always doing the right thing by them. I think whoever this queen is has found peace now. They've already moved off, they've walked off, left all this conflict of this magician in reverse person behind and found peace for themselves. And here they are, sitting center of my spread, looking like the Queen of Cups. Loving, kind, nurturing, intuitive, and ready to fight life one more time. I'm battered, I'm bruised, but I still have my one wand, and with that one wand, I become the Queen of Wands. Temperance. What's this temperance spirit? I think this person found a lot of spiritual healing. Yes, I think they went within, they have been enlightened. I think this Queen of Cups is very intuitive, very enlightened now. They have somehow found their way to connect with, I think, the universe here. And they're getting a lot of healing through that. So who's this hermit in reverse then, spirit? Hermit in reverse. Yes, somebody else who, this is the person, I think, the magician in reverse, who's now feeling, oh my God, I have no hope left anymore. I've lost hope now that my person will ever come back because they seem to be shining bright now. So they're feeling the karmic hit now. They're feeling they're getting bad karma. They feel they've made some very unwise decisions in their life, but they're still holding on. What's the spirit? Four of Pentacles. They want to rebuild. Yes, whoever this person is who's lost this Queen of Cups is feeling they've made some poor choices in their life. Even though they don't have any hope, they are holding on very tightly to the hope that they can once again rebuild what was lost. This person now wants to come forward and offer an apology. So Ten of Swords, Spirit, why does the read end with the Ten of Swords here? Okay. All right. Oh my God. Oh my God. My God. I've got goosebumps right now, Scorpio. I just showed you this card, right? I told you, I said somebody has a lot of boundaries up. They're not going to be taken for a ride anymore. It's almost like this person has said, I've already dropped it. I've already given up. And guess what I get for the clarifiers for the Ten of Swords? This is how this person is feeling now. This person who was foolish, because this queen is saying exactly that. Queen of Swords. Queen of Swords here, right? Same card. And then the Ten of Wands. Look at this. The last card clarified exactly what I said right in the beginning. They have already left the building. This person, this Queen of Swords, has now become too intelligent. They've already gone. They've already dropped this baggage. One more spirit for the Ten of Swords. This was really funny. Okay. The Ten of Swords is again now clarified by the Ten of Swords. My God, what a strong reading this is. I think this connection is already done, over. I think this Queen of Swords is saying, I'm not going back to a structure which never had any firm foundation in the first place. It's already blown up. The tower fell. I mean, it was all built on sand and lies and magician tricking me all the time and no justice, no balance. I am already in a very happy space for myself. I'm connecting with friends, with going out. I'm started to enjoy my life once again. I'm in a very happy place here. And they're making steady progress now. I think this is for this Queen of Cups who's now learnt their lessons, has tapped into their spirituality, and yes, making steady progress. Wonderful. Congratulations, whoever you are. Scorpio, I don't know whether this Queen of Cups is you. Do let me know, okay? That'd be really helpful. And if it resonated, I would love a like, because that shows me how many people are enjoying these videos. And newbies, don't forget to subscribe if you want to meet us next week. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.